Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Temmybanjo, and if it's your first time here, welcome to my channel. You're very welcome, and do me a favor by hitting the subscribe button to my channel and also the notification bell so you do not miss any of my uploads. And today's video is going to be a financial video. I know, and from the title of this video you'd have known what this is all about. So it's a finance video, so get your paper, your biro out so we can get this shmoney. All right, so let's jump right into the video. So first things first, I would like for you to watch this video so you can know about my different streams of income. So because most of the things I might be talking about might sound unfamiliar, and you'll be wondering where is she talking, what she's saying, where is this coming from. So I would like for you to watch this video. I'm going to leave in the card here, so please make sure you check it out and then come back to watch this video, okay, so you do not get lost along the line. So the first thing I did was to have a goal. Like, there was a goal in my head that did not leave, and that's how you just know that is a goal for you. I know some people pray about it, some people, you know, think about it for a long time, but it's just something I created in my head, and it never left my head. Even till now, some of those goals are being actualized and some aren't yet. Hopefully they will, and along the line it's just stuck in my head. So whatever I'm doing is just what I am seeing, what I am working towards. And for you to work towards that goal, you know, you have to be prudent with your money, you have to be smart with your money and all that. So once you have a goal in your mind, you will know what you're doing. Meanwhile, let me just say, I have filmed this video before, but I was filming it off my head and I was just rambling in everything. So this time around, I have, you know, refined my points and comments, or I've refined all I'm saying now. So this is like the best of the best information I am giving you. Paying for master classes, things that will better yourself, things that will push you up in your career path, things that will polish your interest and so on and so forth. So number two will be the fact that you have to work a 9-to-5 to save, especially if you're just out of school. Even if you have something you're doing and it's going to bring you money, it's going to bring you income, please, if you have time, I mean, if your hobby that you have monetized is bringing you an income and you still have time to work that 9-to-5, no money is a waste. Work that 9-to-5 and make sure you make more income. So I have a 9-to-5 which I work, I make money from there, and also from other of my sources of income, my other streams of income. So I was working my 9-to-5, I was doing makeup, I was doing my content creation and so on and so forth. So that way I had enough resources, enough money to gather and to, you know, just pack all my money together. That way my money was in bulk, and it was a lot. So I used some of it to finance some of my projects that I was doing. Most of the money I was getting from my 9-to-5 was put into another of my projects, another of my work, you know, to source out things I'll be needing for work and for content creation, like hair, makeup, lenses, and to buy camera card, just to my equipment and so many other things I use for content creation, pending the time that I was able to make money for my content creation. Okay, so moving on, the third part is that you should invest in bulk and not in bits. I know some of you might be thinking, oh, why should you invest in bulk and not in bits? So first things first, you need to save. And when you're saving, always like be looking out for investment opportunities you can grab on, and the one that will yield you more income or more interest on your investment. And make sure it is secured also. Make sure it is being regulated by your big, like the head body of your banking, whatever, wherever you are in your country. Here my country is CBN. Make sure it's being regulated by CBN. And if you're thinking, why should I invest in bulk and not in bits? When you invest in bits, you automatically get your interest in bits. I mean, whatever comes with it at the end of your period or when your investment is ripe is going to be in bits. So once you save in bulk, once you save maybe 10,000 naira every month, by the end of the month you can have up to 100,000 or even more than. And when you save that, or when you invest rather, when you invest that, when your interest comes back to you, it's going to be in bulk also. So make sure you save, or sorry, make sure you invest in bulk and not in bits. For example, I invested 25,000 naira in, I think, 2016, and in 2018 I was, you know, tired, I needed my money, I was broke and I needed my money. And guess how much I made from 25,000 naira in 2 years? I made 6,000 naira, and it was something. I mean, it was money, I didn't work for it, it was there getting, you know, interest on it and being rolled over and so on and so forth. So just imagine I had invested maybe 100k or even 500,000 or even 1 million naira. Just imagine how much I would have collected if I invested that much. So it is not wise, it's not always smart for you to invest in bits. Rather, you should invest in bulk. The more it is, the more your interest. I hope you get that. So next will be that you should also invest in yourself, as in as much as you want to invest your money, you also need to invest in yourself so that you will bring forth interest. Okay, because let me tell you something, this your mind, you don't know what it can do till you put it to that task. Honestly, till you push yourself. And what do I mean by investing in yourself? You should pay for master classes, attend master classes, be it makeup master class, photography master class, just to perfect your craft. I mean, to be the best that you can be in your field, attend master classes, attend and buy equipment to, you know, boost up your production. For me, it is to buy equipment that will boost up my production, buying items that I can use for filming and production, buying items that I can use for content creation. And you know, if you are a content creator like me, please do not wait for brands to, you know, reach out to you and to notice you. Push yourself there, go and push yourself under them, buy their products, use them, tag them in as much as possible, tag them as much as you can, and before you know it, they will notice you. And you can also reach out to them by sending them mails. But before you even reach out to them, how is your feed doing? That's business for another day. I'm just mentioning that. So how is your feed doing? How is your house? Is it in order? So make sure you build yourself up, you invest in yourself, and that is making sure your products are not the same as maybe it was 5 months ago. So always inspired to do better. That's what I mean by investing in yourself. So all around is just to be gaining knowledge in whatever you're doing, gaining knowledge in whatever field you are, be it business wise, be it photography, be it makeup, be anything you are doing, just gain knowledge. That's what I mean by investing in yourself, because you do not know what your mind can do till you push yourself there. So make sure you gain as much knowledge as you can, because no knowledge is lost. So even when you're saving, I need to mention that you need to have self-control in as much as possible, as things these days are so tempting. I mean, you can afford them, I know you can afford them, but you cannot afford to afford that, if you understand what I'm saying. So please have self-control, be able to control yourself, be able to be contented with what you have. If it is not important that you buy it, please don't even bother, look away. In no time you will be able to afford that, even in tenfold, because maybe that is not the right time for you to get it. So please make sure you have self-control, make sure you are contented with yourself, know what to buy when you need to buy it. I know people are out there saying enjoy a problem till they finish, I know, but there's a way you can portion your money and make sure you just, you know, enjoy the enjoyment you're meant to enjoy and not just lavish. All right, so don't be a compulsive buyer, don't be that person. Always buy things you need and only things you need. Buy things that will elevate your products, elevate your craft, and you know, just things that will better yourself. So finally, I would like to say that you should save. Okay, I've mentioned this earlier in the video, but I'm going to emphasize on it again. Please make sure you save as much as possible. Cultivate the habit of saving. Somebody like me, I am addicted to saving. You see, if I want to buy this eyeshadow palette, I will save towards it. And guess what? Whenever I reach the target, when my money is complete and I can afford this palette, I lose interest. So that's what happens for me. I like to save, and before you know it, when I'm saving to buy something and the money is complete, I just lose interest. I'm like, if the impulse to buy that comes again, I review the reasons why I need to buy it before I move on to buy it. So make sure you save and always know why you're saving, what you're saving towards. That's what I meant by having a goal. And if you can cut costs, for me, cutting costs was having to stay back in my parents' house instead of going out to rent an apartment. That for me is a huge cost I was able to cut. So for the meantime, I am here in my parents' house, living rent free, eating their food for free, and having the time of my life here. I know they are my parents, and it's good of them to house me even after graduation. And some of my mates are out there on their own hustling, and after NYSC like this, they were already making it. And not that I'm not making it, but I'm cutting costs. So in as much as possible, try and cut costs if you can, even in bulk. It will make a big difference, it will go a long way. So I think that's it for this video, and if I do not remember anything, I'm going to leave all that in the comment section or in the description box. And if it's your first time here and you made it up to this point, I definitely think you enjoyed this video. So kindly give this video a thumbs up, and remember to check out the first video where I mentioned my streams of income. And what else? So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, kindly hit the subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, and leave a comment for me in the comment section. And other ways we can make money and just try and elevate ourselves, because in this Nigeria we have to make it. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope to see you in my next one. Bye.